and welcome back to another video with It's Dr. Dan. And today we're going to be learning about how to dilute solutions and to go through many different examples and to explain exactly what it is that you're going to be using when you're in your general chemistry or introductory biology courses, when you have to do dilutions, which is a very common skill that you'll need as a scientist or as a student. So with this formula, what it's all about is we're going to be using the formula above, which is M1V1 is equal to M2V2. So what is that all about? So what are we talking about when it comes to dilutions? So the easiest way to think about it is, let's say I wanted to make Kool-Aid or lemonade or iced tea or something. And when you make it originally, so on the very far left, and you drink it and you realize like, oh, that is way too sweet. What do you do, right? If something is too sweet, too salty, how do you change it? Well, usually the first thing you do is you dilute it, right? You add a little bit of water. So when you do that, so let's say if I started to over here on the far left and I add a little bit of water and I keep adding water, one thing you'll notice is the color is going to change. It's going to get lighter and lighter and lighter. Why is that happening? Well, because the concentration of the juice that's in that powder is getting less and less and less, meaning you're not going to taste it as much. It's being diluted. So it's becoming less sweet. And that's the whole idea of dilution. We're making our solutions less sweet in a way, or less moles in our solution. So this is what we're going to be exploring when we're looking at this. So let's take a look, and this is going to be a skill that you're going to use in the lab. That's very common. So let's try to figure out how to do different calculations for it and how to utilize it for your chemistry course. So the first thing is, when we're looking at M1V1 is equal to M2V2, is that, as you may have realized, this is a relationship between concentration and volume. So why M instead of maybe another letter? M is usually representing of molarity, meaning that's usually the most common concentration that's used in chem. However, you might have also seen the version of the formula above, which is C1V1 is equal to C2V2. Both formulas are identical because they are an inverse relationship, meaning that as volume goes up, concentration goes down. So if you like one version or the other, they'll both work the same as long as you're using your concentration as C or M. So what I'm trying to get to is that this formula can be used for molarity, for percents, for molality. It can be used for any of the concentrations as long as the units are matching on both sides. So meaning molarity has to cancel molarity, millimoles have to cancel millimoles, liters have to cancel liters, everything needs to match on the left and right. So let's take a look at some examples of how exactly we can use this for our skills so that we can do the best that we can in our 1.3 molar solution needs to have a final concentration of 0.0400 molarity. What the heck does that even mean? So when we're doing this, being that, as you remember, the formula was M1V1 is equal to M2V2. So the first thing I would recommend doing is with these is stay organized. It's talking about making a new solution. So you see that there's change involved. So when it's talking about this of making a new solution, that's the same chemicals, it's talking about diluting it. So what we're going to do is we're going to write out M1, V1, M2, V2, and all of that separately. And we're going to see is which pieces were we given. So at the very beginning of the problem, it says we have 10 milliliters of a 1.30 molar solution. So that's on the second line here. Now, what those represent are those two terms are together, meaning they're part of the same solution. So we're going to label that as solution one, and they are together. It doesn't matter if they're one or two, as long as they go together. That's the most important part. So the molarity, you have 10 milliliters of 1.30 molar. And it wants to know what the final volume is. So we'll put a question mark by that. And it says that the concentration is 0.0400 molarity. Okay, looks good. So now what we're going to do is we're going to plug all this into our equation. We want V2, so we'll move things around a little bit and get V2 by itself. So divide M2 by both sides. So now what we will have is we'll take 1.30 molar times that by 10 milliliters. And then we're going to divide that by 0.0400 molarity. Okay. And now the one thing you're going to notice is you'll see that the molarity, being that these are the same units, they're going to cancel each other out, which is really important to kind of realize here that both these two cancel. Now, what this is going to leave you is only with milliliters. So we're going to do 1.3 times 10, and then we're going to divide that by 0.05, and we get 325 milliliters of our solution here. And this will be your final answer for your first dilution problem. So not too bad, right? So, and this is kind of the general idea of how we put all these together. Let's take a look at another problem of working with dilutions. You have 0.600 molar NaCl stock solution. You need to make 500 milliliters of a 20 millimolar dilution. What volumes do you add? So sometimes you might be told when you walk into a lab is that you need to make this. And you're like, what? What do you mean I need to do that? It's not always given to you, which is sometimes really scary, and especially the first time you have to do it. So once again, what we're going to do is we're going to write down everything that we had. So it says you have a 0.600 molar NaCl solution. So let's write down that first thing. So that's M1. So we got 0.600 molar. Now, that's referred to as a stock solution. What does that mean? So a stock solution refers to the most concentrated solution that you have available, meaning it's like what's available in the stock room or the prep room. So it's what you have on hand. So if it's your stock solution, you can't go any more concentrated than that. You can only go down. So you can dilute. You can't go upwards. So remember that for later. So you need to make 500 milliliters of a 20 millimolar solution. So we actually don't know what volume one is because it's asking us what we're adding. But we do know V2, which is 500 mLs. And we know M2, which is 20 millimoles. All right. So what else is kind of a problem here? Well, notice how the units don't quite match. So we have 20 millimoles here. And then we have 0.600 molar up here. So what we need to do is essentially convert this guy on the bottom to molar. So we'll divide this number by 1,000. We'll get 0.0200 molarity. Now we can plug all this into our formula. So when we are to do this, we are going to have V1 is equal to M2V2 divided by M1. So we'll take 0.0200 times that by 500. And it's as you kind of notice how important it was to make sure the units match, because if they don't, then you're not going to get a right answer. So we'll see that we have 0.600 molar on bottom. The two terms cancel out, which is great. And what that's going to leave us with is 16.7 milliliters of solution is required. So now what this refers to is this exactly how you make the solution? It's not. This is only part of it. So if you were to do this and you were, what volume do you need? I didn't specify anything. So sometimes you need to make the whole thing. So this refers to in here is 16.7 milliliters of your stock solution, which is what you will add first to your flask. Now, being that it's talking about making a 500 milliliter solution, you would dilute this volume, the 16.7 milliliters here, with DI water. So what you would do is you take your little DI water bottle, you would fill up the vol flask here with the rest of it with water up to the line on your volumetric flask to get 500 milliliters. So essentially to make your solution is you would fill the rest with DI water. Now, could you just calculate it and you'd get like 483.3 or whatever number it is? Yeah, you would, but you got to keep in mind is you want to fill it to the glassware because it's calibrated. So we fill the rest with the eye water is the right answer. Let's take a look at another problem. You need to make 4 liters of a 0.900% saline solution. You check the storeroom and you find 0.450% and a 20% saline solution. What do you use to make this? And what volume of that solute do you need to add to make your solution? Okay, so this is a tough one. Let's take a look. So what it says is let's write everything down. So our volume two is we need to make 4 liters with a concentration of 0.900%. And from that, we are trying to figure out what our original volume is. And we have a couple options for volume for the molarity here, which is pretty common in terms of a chemistry lab. What do you use to make this? Now, the thing is, you need to dilute the stock solution to do this. So if we were to kind of put these over here, which one can you dilute? Can you dilute 0.450% to 0.9? Or can you dilute 20% to 0.9? Which one is making it less sweet, as per se, or less salty in this case? Which one is that? Well, if you think about it, well, that is going to be the 20%. Because it's more concentrated, you need to go down. You cannot go up. So we will use a 20% here, and we're going to set it up just like how we did the last problem. So being that they're percents, the beauty of this is that they'll cancel each other out when we are trying to solve this. So we'll have 0.9% times 4, divide that by 20%, and you can see here is that the percents will cancel, being that they're made of the same thing. So what this will give you is 0.180 liters is what's required to make this, which to kind of put that in normal speak, like there's nothing that measures just liters in the lab. This would be about 180 milliliters is how much you would use of your solute. So if you were to try to do the solvent part, you would fill it up to 4 liters of your vessel to make the rest of the solution. Okay, so this has been all my examples in dilution. So I try to go through some different examples of real practical examples for how to do this. I hope that this helped you understand it a little bit more for something that you will have to do in the lab. If you need any help, feel free to comment below, message me, hit the like button, subscribe if you haven't before, and I hope to see you back for future videos. Thank you so much for listening, and I hope you have a wonderful day. I'll see y'all later. Bye now.